In the period just preceding the First World War, the French filmmaker Louis Fayard created a number of film serials based upon certain novels by Pierre Sauvestre and Marcel Alain, which had obsessed the Parisian imagination in the few years preceding, recounting the exploits of mysterious, phantasmagoric Parisian criminals. These films, placed in secret parts of the French imagination, the faintly etched images of the black-hatted Detective Judex, the vampiress Irma Vep, and the mysterious and elusive Fantomas. Yes, yes, you heard me correctly. I spoke the name of the elusive Fantomas. How was that, you ask? I said, Fantomas. But what, you ask, is Fantomas? Who, you ask, is Fantomas? Nobody. But somebody, nevertheless. And what, you ask, does this somebody do? He frightens.
Read the evening paper, relax. Look, look, my name across the page, black headline.
The young journalist, Max Beauchamp, held prisoner by Fantomas, perhaps, in love with the innocent Helene, daughter of Fantomas himself.
I do not look at you.
Have you ever seen me before?
No!
No, it isn't Helene.
Thank you.
not a
hotel bill. I hope you've enjoyed your stay.
The gentleman criminal, Monsieur Gaston, and his well-known whirling walk of terror.
What kind of people stay here? What?
The petite and insolent Alain Duchamp and his famous hopstep snapshot on the Boulevard du Crime.
Where do you keep your disguises?
In the top drawer of my bureau.
Rarely seen. The notorious Promenade des Criminels. Featuring in advance the delicate Jolo L'Angeleur. And bringing up the rear, the notorious Dr. Lacloche, medical faculty, the Sorbonne, surgical division.
Have a look, if you like.
Will you untie my hands?
Of course! You haven't untied them yet.
Will you marry my daughter?
What better way for Jutex, friend of all victims, to secretly install himself at the side of the terrified Max? Yes, yes, priestly vestments, since a marriage is being suggested.
Excuse-moi!
So I kissed the maiden, I bounced her on my knee. And she acted brave and returned my kiss to me. And she said,
young man, you are in the bridal suite.
And I knew at once I had swept her.
They see an omen, perhaps a bird of foreboding. She is reading the romance of her own story.
Where is the second room? Where is the second room that is really beautiful? How do I find the second room, which is a room of adventure? Found the second room, which is the room of adventure.
What you are about to see will cause you to reflect. Can such things happen, even in the dark back streets of Paris? Can such things be allowed to occur? Can such people be allowed to be what they are, do what they do, frighten whom they frighten?
Just 25 seconds after a slight readjustment of decor, we present part two of Hotel for Criminals.
Sure.
in. The street is deserted. Max sits with his beloved and says to himself, "Do I recognize her? Do I know where I am? A bird flies across the sky."
Now the frightful bird is close to me. Now we can look at each other and compare each other's faces. Look, look, that is the face of my fear. Look, look, its wings are like the night. Look, look, it has no name, but it has a body. Look, look, all of the others are afraid. I am afraid too.
Why is that woman looking at me?
Which one is Helene? Why can't I tell which one is Helene?
Which one is Irma Bapp, the temptress and criminal? And which, I repeat, which one is Helene, my beloved?
I accuse the mob that does.
Evil, depravity, but another perspective exists. Behind closed doors, the monstrous ones, without the protection of the night, an insight. Their private inertia. No past, no future, no memory, no anticipation.
The gentleman sits staring, though his eyes are on the moon. The morning sun is shining, and it makes his daughter swoon. The lady in the ermine coat says, rub your daughter's back. I'd like to make her happy, but I haven't got the knack.
We all have different demons, and we hide them very well. The
tigre. Seems a pair of wings. Not really like an angel's heart. Just imitation.
With the criminals and phantoms surrounding her, Helene is as if an angelic being who sees beauty no matter which way she faces. She is mistaken, of course, and so something bad will happen to her. Something bad will happen. Something bad. Bad. She does. She puts a finger in the aperitif glass, tips it, and the liquor dribbles to the floor.
It's not fair. How do you recall?
Do you know that a serious and bizarre accident has been reported? A daughter has been struck by an automobile. A beloved daughter. A pure, innocent daughter.
Thank you.
cage. If ever you need my help.
Question. Who was hit by the silver car of Fantomas? Your answer may not be the right answer.
I've been hit by a silver car. I've been hit by a silver car. Help me off my knees. Help me off my knees so I may search for the lead.
Just because I'm damaged, there's no need to cover me with a sheet. I cannot see. That's a disadvantage. Just be. Cause I'm dizzy, yeah.